So one of the little known features inside MacroWorks is our mouse functions. And in order to show you something about those, what we're going to do is, you see I have a stuff folder on my desktop, and I have these junk folders scattered around the desktop. And so to clean up the desktop, I'm going to program an X key that will click down on one of these files wherever I am, drag it over the stuff folder, and let go. Save me all the arduous trouble of doing that myself. But hey, that's the example we're going to use. So to start out, I'm going to press this key on my X keys to open it for programming. I'm going to go to the Functions tab and then click the Show Functions button. Now you see the list of functions we have here. We have, among other things, mouse, and we have buttons and movements. So what we want is we're going to start with a button. I want the left down. I don't want to click because a click means I press and release it, and that's not going to help me. So left down is the first thing I want. Here it is in my list. Now that I have the button down, I want to move over to that spot where the folder is. So I'm going to go to movements. It's an absolute movement. I'm going to go to the same spot on the desktop every time. So this is the function I want. Now that I have selected that, you see it's going to ask me to input the X and Y coordinates of where I want to go on the desktop. And how do I know where this folder is? If you come back over here to our Tools menu in MacroWorks, there's something called the Mouse Button Cursor Utility, and we select that. And now if you see these X and Y values here, you'll see that they are tracking my cursor wherever I go on the desktop. So I hover over that stuff folder. I'm at roughly 418 in the X coordinates and 34 in the Y. Come back into my programming window, and I believe I said 413. And I'll say 35 for the Y. That'll get me there. As I was editing this tutorial, I discovered a feature in the mouse button cursor utility and thought I would insert this little bit of video to tell you about it. And you notice the X and Y values changing as I move my cursor around. Well, I can hover over something and hit any key on my keyboard, and it will freeze the values. So now I can come back over to MacroWorks and enter the values and not have to remember them or write them down somewhere. Neat little feature, and now back to the tutorial. So now I've grabbed the file, moved it up to the folder. Now I could, you know, you would think that I would just want to at that point bring the left button up to release it. But if I do that all on the press of the X key, it will not allow for enough time for this or the file to travel back to that folder. Again, I could add a delay in here, but I'm too lazy to do that. So I'm just going to come down to the release macro event and then put the mouse left up event in on the release of the key. And I'm going to save that. While we're here, let's just do this key above it. And on that one, I'm just going to do a very simple button left down up. And if you see when I do that, it puts two events in, one in the press of the key, one in the release. It's going to hold the mouse button down while I have the key down. It's going to release it when I bring it up. Save that one. Okay, close utility. Minimize this for now. So if this works correctly, I can hover over this junk file, press my key, and when I release, it's going into the folder. And do that again. Again, I have to bring my cursor back. Oh, that's work, but hey, this is accurately taking those files to the same location every time and dropping them. Now, the other key we programmed, I just wanted to show you that it does the same thing as holding the mouse button down. I hold the the X key down, I can drag this around and then let go of it. Why would I want that? We do have people who use that because of RSI issues. You know, when you're clicking all the time with the same finger, you can develop an injury. And so this allows you to use a different finger, or you could even put it on a foot pedal or something like that. So there's my tutorial. Hope that was informative, and I look forward to your questions.